Hi friends, in this session we will discuss about an introduction to theory of computation. So coming under theory of computation, the basic term we have to know is finite automata. So the main purpose of finite automata is to recognize strings or to recognize a language. To recognize either a language or strings, we are using finite automata. In simple terms, a finite automata is a mathematical model. Finite automata represents a mathematical model. By using this finite automata, strings or languages are determined. Now, finite automata is divided into two types. One is deterministic finite automata and the second one is non-deterministic finite automata. One is a deterministic finite automata and the second one is non-deterministic finite automata. So step by step we will discuss both DFA and NFA. First we will move to deterministic finite automata, DFA. So deterministic finite automata is DFA is represented by using 5 tuples. That is the finite automata, that the mathematical model is represented by using 5 tuples. So what are the tuples? Q, sigma, delta, Q naught, F. These are the 5 tuples that are used in DFA. What are the meaning of those tuples? Q. Q represents the set of states. Q represents set of states that are used in the finite automata, and sigma represents input symbols. Sigma represents input symbols, that is what are the inputs we are providing for moving from one state to another state, and Q naught represents initial state. Initial state means from the given set of states, initially we have to start from one state. So that state is represented as initial state. For every finite automata, we have only one initial state. We have only one initial state, whatever that is, but we have only one initial state, F. F represents final state. Final state means where we stop the procedure. That is, whenever the string is accepted, compulsory we have to place at final state. By reaching the final state only, the string is accepted. For a given finite automata, we have any number of final states. And finally, delta. Delta represents a transition function. Delta is a transition function. Transition means moving from one state to another state. That means delta represents in the given set of states, by taking an input symbol, the given Q represents set of states, sigma represents input symbols. In the given set of states, by taking an input symbol, we are moving to one more state. We are moving to one more state. This is a transition function. So this transition is represented as delta. In simple terms, from the given current state, by taking an input, it moves to exactly one state. Simple terms, in simple terms we have any Q path. That means for a given state, for the given input, we have only one path. Compulsory each and every state, for all the inputs, we have to provide a path, and the path must be any Q path. These are the terms and this is the representation of deterministic finite automata. Next we will discuss one example, a simple example, because this is just introduction session. suppose design a deterministic finite automata, design a deterministic finite automata that ends with 0 0. Suppose I want to design a deterministic finite automata that ends with 0 0 with input symbols are 0 comma 1, with input symbols are 0 comma 1. So clearly identify the question, we have to design DFA. The same example we will discuss in NFA also. First we will discuss, we have to design DFA, and the condition is every finite automata that ends with 0 0, that means the strings are like this, and we have two types of input symbols, either 0 1. For example, the possible strings are 0 0, 1 0 0, 0 1 0 0, 1 1 1 0 0. So whatever this is, the last two strings, the last two things must be 0 0. Before 0 0 we have any terms. Construct the DFA that accepts these types of strings. Now you not simply observe the point, we have compulsory these two terms. So first to write these two terms, Q naught on 0, that means on state Q naught, by taking input 0 it moves to state Q1, state Q naught, and observe I am starting from Q naught. So Q naught is considered as initial state. For initial state it is represented with arrow mark. For initial state, before the state, we are representing arrow mark. That means Q naught is initial state. On Q naught, by taking input 0, we are moving to Q1. On Q1, taking input 0, we are moving to Q2. So our condition is satisfied. Our condition is satisfied. Starting from Q0, ending with Q2. That means by reaching this Q2, our condition has to be satisfied. That means Q2 becomes a final state. Final state is represented with a double circle. Observe the strings. First string, start from Q0, 0, 0, and reach the final state. The string is accepted. But what about the remaining strings? So our concept is, from every state we have to two inputs, we have to provide two inputs. From Q0 on 0 we are providing some mark. From Q0 on 1, Q0 on 1 we are providing no input. So simply Q0 on 1. Suppose Q0 on 1, we are moving to Q0 only, because the string always ends with 0 0. Suppose Q1, on Q1 also I am writing the transition as 1. Q1, by providing input, it moves to Q0. Q2, from Q2 we have 0 comma 1. Clearly observe why we are writing this one. The string always ends with 0 0. For example, if you are writing 1, the string is 001, it doesn't satisfy the condition. So whenever we are reaching the final state, before reaching the final state, it must ensure 00. Observe any string, for example the string 100. So observe for this one 100, and from this 100, again we reach the final state. So this is the way we are constructing design automata. So if it is satisfied or not is satisfied, simply represented as delta of. So observe this string, if the string is satisfied or not satisfied, delta of initial state is Q0. Initial state is Q0. On Q0, taking the input as 0 0. Delta on Q0, this is the string. After completion of this string, if we reach Q2, our answer is H. So check, this is the way represented. First to delta of Q0 on 1, Q0 on 1, it moves to a state again q naught. That means delta of q naught comma q naught on 1 is completed and remaining string is 1100. Again q naught on again 1, q naught on again 1. So delta of q naught comma 100. So again q naught on again 1. So q naught on 1 again moves to q naught. Delta of q naught comma 00. Next q naught on input 0. So scan, this is input string, scan the string from left to right, letter by letter. Q naught on 0, we are moving to q1. That means delta of q1 comma remaining character is 0. Next q1 on 0, we are moving to q2, and no input is required. Finally we are writing q2. Here q2 is a final state. That means our string is accepted, our string is accepted. Okay, clear? Suppose consider one more example. I am writing the example as this one. I am writing this example as this one. 111 01, q naught on 1, we are moving to q naught. So same example, q1 on 1, q1 on 1, it moves to q naught. So all inputs are completed and q naught is the not final state. Q naught is not final state means the string 111 01 is not accepted. 111 01 is not accepted because it does not satisfy our condition. Our condition is the string always ends with 00. But in this case, our strings end with 01. This is the way we are checking whether the string is accepted by the given finite automata or not. And the finite automata is represented in one more way, that is called transition table. Finite automata is represented by using transition table. So the table is represented as, on rows we are providing states, that means q0, q1, q2. Q0, q1, q2 represents rows. Column represents the input symbols. So simply q0 on input symbol 0, q0 on input symbol 0, it moves to state q1. Q naught on input symbol 1, Q naught on input symbol 1, it moves to state Q naught. Q1 on input symbol 0, it moves to Q2. Q1 on input symbol 1, it moves to Q naught. Finally, Q naught on 0 moves to Q naught. Q2 on 1 moves to Q naught. This is a transition table for this deterministic finite automata. So according to our example, check for each and every state we have two input symbols 0 and 1. For each and every state it must and should transition from 0 and 1, and only 1 0 and 1 1 is provided. Suppose for q0 we have a path with only 1 0, two zeros are not allowed. If it is allowed, that is becomes NFA. This is deterministic finite automata. So in the next session, we will discuss some of the examples of deterministic finite automata. Thank you.